you know, when I give lectures to students, I frequently make the point out to them how they're doing this glucoraphane into sulforaphane conversion. So I'll do it for this webinar. When you chew on a red radish, you're familiar with the fact that the first sensation is cool and crunchy, and then within 20, 30 seconds, you develop heat, you start tearing, your nose starts running, it has a lacrimating effect. So what you're doing is you're acting like that insect that I told you lands on the leaf of a broccoli plant. You're breaking the plant cells by crunching on the radish. You're releasing a compound that's very, very similar to glucoraphane, and it's actually called glucoraphanine in radishes. It happens to be more of a lacrimator. It's got a more mucus-inducing effect in people. And you're letting myrosinase in those radish tissues act on glucoraphanine and form sulforaphane and some other related isothiocyanates. That's the broad name for that category. So it happens that fast when you chew on fresh vegetables that contain this system.
Does sulforaphane also activate NRF2?
It does, but to a lesser degree than sulforaphane.
So many of these isothiocyanates also activate NRF2, but not to the same degree as sulforaphane.
They do. And just in case you're about to ask me, you find this system. It's been dubbed the mustard oil bomb by some 20 or 30 years ago. You find this system in almost exclusively in cruciferous vegetables,
right,
or brassica vegetables, or coal crops, they're sometimes called, depending upon where you come from, where you hail from. In Eastern Europe, they typically call them coal crops. So this happens to be a very large family of, I don't know, 500 or 600 genera, many, many thousands of species.
Yeah, I know like maybe 10 of them.
Well, we know maybe 20, but yeah. I mean, there are very many of them. And they grow worldwide, although the brassica or the coal crops that we're familiar with in the United States are all temperate climate crops. They're common to areas where there's a freeze, a cold winter or a freeze in the winter.
I wanted to ask you something because you mentioned it really piqued my attention. As you said, that broccoli seeds actually had higher amount of glucoraphanin than the sprout. Is it, if I were to say take those broccoli seeds, because I sprout, if I were to take those broccoli seeds, add a little water and blend them in a blender, would that activate myrosinase within the seed, the crushing of the seed?
You bet.
I could get a higher, more potent amount of sulforaphane, theoretically, if I were to just take the seeds, and be easier than sprouting,
that's,
in a way.
That's true. So, interestingly, when we discovered that, and this was published in 1997, so it's ancient history. It's probably before you were born, right? So when we discovered that broccoli sprouts and seeds were such a potent source of sulforaphane, or its precursor, we weren't aware that anybody had eaten broccoli seeds. People eat, all sorts of seeds, poppy seeds and rapeseed or canola seed, in fact, are used to express oil, and they're a close relative. But no one had eaten broccoli seeds. And when we tried them, they're quite bitter. But interestingly, if you bake them just gently, don't scorch them, if you bake them, they're a very nutty taste. And they're sort of pleasant tasting. The problem is if you bake them, you kill the enzyme, you kill myrosinase.
Right, so that's something important to mention.
Right. There actually have been some epidemiologic studies, and I'm getting off topic a bit, but some epidemiologic studies suggesting that people who eat certain amounts of cruciferous vegetables have reduced risks of various cancers. Breast cancer and lung cancer are high on the list of cancers that have been studied. Excuse me. And it turns out that if you eat raw cruciferous vegetables, you're a bit better protected, again, based on the epidemiology. This has not been the subject of interventions randomized clinical trials, for example. But it looks like the protective effect is greater if you eat raw vegetables. Mm-hmm. But now a lot of people don't like to eat raw, you know, cauliflower or broccoli or well, radishes they do. But so at any rate, you asked about the content in broccoli seeds, and indeed they have much more glucoraphanin, and they have plenty of active myrosinase. But I have a feeling, I've never made a smoothie from raw broccoli seeds. I have a feeling it'd be pretty bitter.
I'll let you know, because I'm going to try it.
I thought you might.